Good morning, welcome to online class. Today we are going to revise the lesson from geography part. Geography part we have completed the fourth lesson. Today we are continuing the fifth chapter, that is biosphere. Revise the question onwards and the question answers. Okay, the first, choose the correct answer. The coldest biome on earth is tundra. The biome is very cold, hot, cold. That is tundra region. Tundra biome is coldest biome on earth. This is the smallest unit of biosphere. Ecosystem is the cold. Smallest unit of biosphere. Third one, nutrients are recycled in the atmosphere with the help of certain microorganisms referred to as. The answer is none of the above. To which climate conditions are xerophytic plants specifically adapted to? Saline and sandy. Xerophytous plants specifically adapted to saline and sandy. Then the fifth one, why is the usage of rainforest biomes for large scale agriculture unsustainable? Why is the usage of rainforest biomes for large scale agriculture unusable? Why? The D option, because the soil is poor soil, fertility or anything, it is poor soil, so it is not useful for large scale agriculture. Then the next sixth one, that is question and that is ascertained reason, ascertained type questions. That is 6 to 8 or ascertained type question. The sixth one answer is A option, that is both ascertained and reason are true, or is explained A. R explains A. That is reason explains A. Seventh one also option A is correct option. So sixth and seventh A option. Both ascertain and reason are true or explains A. Eighth one, the option is C, D option. Sorry, C option. A is true but R is false. Ascertain is true, reason is false. That is C option. Fill in the blanks. An area where animals, plants and microorganisms live and interact with one another is known as ecosystem. Here, the animals, plants and microorganisms live and interact with one another. Then the second one is, DAS are called heterotrophs. Consumers are also called heterotrophs. Food web is a system of interlocking and independent food chain. Food web is a system of interlocking and independent food chain. Biome is an extensive large ecosystem. Fifth one, the vegetative type commonly found in desert biome is called xerophytes. Xerophytes found in the desert biome is called xerophytes. Sixth one, Estuary is an aquatic biome that is found where fresh water and salt water mix, mostly in the coastal region between the land and the sea. The fresh water and salt water mix will be the where the rivers meet in the sea or the ocean. There will be a fresh water and the salt water mix will be there. That is estuary. Then the two more questions. Answer the following in brief. First one, what is biosphere? What is biosphere? That is page number 202. The introduction it is given. Biosphere, the fourth sphere of the Earth, is a life-supporting layer that exists on Earth's surface. On Earth's surface, it is the biosphere giving the life. It is a life sphere. It is a fourth sphere. It is a life-supporting sphere. This is on the Earth. It is on the surface, Earth's surface. This layer on Earth encompasses the lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere. It includes flora, fauna that thrive on or near the Earth's surface. Thrive on near the Earth's surface. This flora and fauna grow on Earth's surface. It is found in the biosphere. It is a life supporting sphere. Life supporting sphere means it gives a life to plants and animals. Plants and animals. And some other spheres also there. Atmosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere. All these are all life supporting spheres only. Along with that, this biosphere also life supporting sphere. It supports the life of the flora and fauna, that is plants and animals. What is an ecosystem? That is page number 202, ecosystem. About under the heading ecosystem, an ecosystem is a community where all living organisms live and interact with one another and also with their non-living environment such as land, soil, air, water, etc. As an ecosystem is a community where all living organisms live and interact with one another and also with their non-living environment such as land, soil, air, water. Non-living environment means living environment and non-living environment. The living and non-living environment found in the ecosystem. An ecosystem is a community where all living organisms live and interact with one another and also with their own non-living environment such as land, soil, air and water. Up to that, you have to mark it and learn. What does the term biodiversity mean? Third one. What does the term biodiversity mean? That is page number 204. Page number 204. Under the heading biodiversity. Biodiversity or biological diversity refers to a wide variety of living organisms, plants, animals, and other microorganisms which live in a habitat. It is highly influenced by topography, climatic as well as human activities. That is biodiversity. Biodiversity or biological diversity, a wide variety of living organisms. Wide variety of living organisms in the sense plants, animals and other microorganisms which live in a habitat. It is highly influenced by topography, climatic as well as human activities. Human activities, that is biodiversity. Then the fifth one mentioned the various terrestrial biomes. That also page number 204. Terrestrial biomes. Where some of the major terrestrial biomes of the world are, it is various terrestrial biomes. Yes, tropical forest biomes, tropical savanna biomes, desert biomes, temperate grassland biomes, tundra biomes. These are all the various terrestrial biomes. Various terrestrial biomes. First one is tropical forest biomes, tropical region. Tropical temperature, high temperature region. That is tropical forest biomes. There are dense forests are there. Then tropical savanna biomes, savannas. Also. Then desert biomes, deserts also found. And terrestrial biomes. Temperate grassland biomes. Temperate grasslands, that also more useful for grazing animals, temperate grasslands. Different temperate grasslands are there, that is called in different names in different countries. Tundra biomes, tundra, it is coldest biome, tundra biomes. These are all the different biomes are found in the terrestrial biomes. Give reasons for the following. Producers are also called autotrophs. Give reason for the following. Producers are also called autotrophs. Page number 203. Page number 203. Give reason. Producers are also called autotrophs. Page number 203, biotic components heading second para. Biotic components heading second para. Producers are self-nourishing components of the ecosystem. Hence they are called autotrophs. Producers are self-nourishing components of the ecosystem. Hence they are called autotrophs. They are producing their own food. Self-producers are called autotrophs. Then the next one, biosphere provides a stable ecosystem. Give reason, biosphere provides a stable ecosystem, that also page number 2, that is page number 202. Page number 202. Under the heading ecosystem, last three lines. Biosphere harbors all ecosystems on the earth and sustain life forms, including mankind. Biosphere harbors all ecosystems on the earth and sustains life forms including mankind. Here including mankind, giving life for all living organisms on earth. That is biosphere. Here the life is possible, the biosphere. It includes all other spheres. This it orbits all ecosystems on earth and sustains life forms including mankind. It life supporting sphere. biosphere is the life supporting sphere on earth. Okay, we have revised this all these one words and short answer answered the following briefly and give reasons for the following your reasons for the following the two following we have revised. Remaining that distinguish between the following, answer the following a paragraph. We'll see later the next period we can see. Thank you.
Yeah.